ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாசுரம். மார்கழி திங்கள் மதி நிறைந்த நன்னாளால் நீராட போதுவீர் போதுமினோ நேரிழையீர் சீர்மல்குமாய்ப்பாடி செல்வ சிறுமீர்காள் கூர்வேல் கொடுந்தொழிலன் அந்த கோபன் குமரன் ஏரார்ந்த கண்ணிய சோதையிளம் சிங்கம் கார்மேனி செங்கண் கதிர்மதியம் போல் முகத்தான் நாராயணனே நமக்கே பறை தருவான் பாரோர் புகழ படிந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். நர்ச்சர்ட் வித் கிருஷ்ண பக்தி பை ஹர் ஃபாதர் பெரியாழ்வார், ஆண்டாள் க்ரூ அப் வித் தி டிசையர் ஆஃப் மேரிங் த லார்ட். பீயிங் தி இன்கார்னேஷன் ஆஃப் பூமி தேவி, இட் வாஸ் பட் நேச்சுரல் தட் ஷீ ஹேட் சச் அ டிசையர். பெரியாழ்வார் ஹட் டோல்ட் ஹர் தட் ஹர் டிசையர் வுட் சர்டன்லி பி ஃபுல்ஃபில்ட் பட் அட் இட்ஸ் ஓன் அப்ராப்ரியேட் டைம். ஸோ டு ஸ்பெண்ட் த டைம் டில் ஷீ ஆக்சுவலி குட் கோ அண்ட் அட்டெயின் த லார்ட், ஆண்டாள் டிசைடட் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் தி பாவை நோம்பு வித் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். தி பாவை நோம்பு வாஸ் அன் இமிட்டேஷன் ஆஃப் தி காத்தியாயனி விரதா தட் வாஸ் பெர்ஃபார்ம்ட் பை கோபிகாஸ் டியூரிங் த கிருஷ்ணாவதாரா டு அட்டெயின் லார்ட் கிருஷ்ணா. ஸோ ஆல்சோ ஆண்டாள் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் பெர்ஃபார்மிங் அ சிமிலர் விரதா ஆர் நோம்பு கால்ட் அஸ் த பாவை நோம்பு. And the way she went ahead to perform this Pavai Nombu is described in the ThiruppAvai. The ThiruppAvai is a beautiful composition of 30 verses which is extremely structured. The 30 verses of the ThiruppAvai can be divided into 6 scenes, each scene having 5 verses or 5 pasurams. So in the first scene, ஆண்டாள் டிஸ்கிரைப்ஸ் அபவுட் ஹவு எக்ஸாக்ட்லி ஷீ இஸ் கோயிங் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் தி பாவை நோம்பு. ஒன் திங் தட் ஆண்டாள் வாஸ் ஷியூர் ஆஃப் வாஸ் தட் ஷீ டிட் நாட் வாண்ட் திஸ் டிவைன் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் ஃபார் ஹர் செல்ஃப் அலோன். தட்ஸ் தி வெரி ரீசன் வை ஷீ கேம் டவுன் அஸ் ஆண்டாள். ஷீ வாஸ் பூமி தேவி ஹூ வாஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் இன் டிவைன் அசோசியேஷன், பட் ஷீ தாட் தட் திஸ் டிவைன் அசோசியேஷன் தட் ஷீ வாஸ் என்ஜாயிங் should be enjoyed by all her children. So, taking everyone into her fold for divine experience was her very nature. That's why she is known as Kshama, the most tolerant one and the most benevolent one. So, Andal calls all her friends to participate in this Pavai Nombu. And it so happens that on a full moon night, she asks her friends to assemble in a place in an open ground called Pavai Kalam. And here she holds a meeting in which she's trying to tell her friends what this Pavai Nombu is all about. So she starts speaking in the first verse. She says, மார்கழி திங்கள் மதி நிறைந்த நன்னாளால். மை டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், இன் திஸ் ஆஸ்பிஷியஸ் மந்த் ஆஃப் மார்கழி, வென் த மூன் இஸ் இன் ஃபுல் ப்ளூம், மதி நிறைந்த ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு த மூன் பீயிங் இன் ஃபுல் ப்ளூம். மதி மீன்ஸ் மூன், நிறைந்த இஸ் த ஒன் விச் இஸ் பிளாசம்ட். So in this blossomed full moon night of the month of Margari, we are going to perform our Pavai Nombu. So she talks about the time of performance of the Pavai Nombu first. Now why has Andal chosen this month of Margari to do the Pavai Nombu? The answer is very simple. Andal likes whatever Krishna is associated with. And Lord Krishna has said in the Bhagavad Gita that amongst months he is the month of Margari. Masanam margasir shoham are his words in the Gita. So since the Lord identifies himself as the month of Margari, Andal decides to do her vrata for the Lord also in the month of Margari. Not only this, but also the month of Margari is supposed to be very, very apt for divine experiences, because it is said that a year span in a man's life is equivalent to a day's span in the life of the celestials or the devas. The devas, who are supposed to be residing in heaven or swargam, live a longer life than us, and the duration of their day is equivalent to the duration of our year. So, during our year, we encounter this month of Margari, which is equivalent to the dawn period of the day of the devas. Dawn is the time when our mind can concentrate at its maximum and it can concentrate on virtuous things. So, the entire month of Margari actually makes us capable of giving more concentration to virtuous aspects. That is why Andal chooses the month of Margari to perform her vratam. So she tells her friends that in the month of Margari, when the moon is in full bloom, we are going to perform our vrata. Andal talks about the moon right at the beginning, because it is said that the moon is supposed to be a sign of auspiciousness. And this prabandham, or this work of Andal, the ThiruppAvai, is known as Mangala Prabandham, or the auspicious work. So, every word of ThiruppAvai is auspicious and will convey something auspicious. So, right in the beginning, Andal talks about the moon, which signifies auspiciousness. Next, she clarifies as to who is eligible for this vrata. Who all can do this vrata? She says, Neerada poduveer podumino neerilayir. She says, the ones who want to get immersed in this ocean of devotion, they are all eligible for this vrata. Neerada poduveer means the ones who wish to get immersed in this path of devotion. So, all the eligibility that a person has to have is the desire to be devoted. So, if one wants to be devoted to the Lord, that is enough to do anything and everything for Him. So, Andal just clarifies that so beautifully in this sentence. Neerada poduveer podumino. All those who are desirous of being devoted, being immersed in devotion, please come. And she says, Neerirayir. Neerirayir means you girls who are all into the path of virtue. Now, when Andal starts talking to her friends, she doesn't first address them as Neerirayir and start the pasuram. Instead, she starts talking the topic first. This signifies that the topic was important to both Andal and the crowd which was hearing it. They were more keen on hearing what was being addressed rather than how they are being addressed. So, Andal keeps the address to the crowd secondary and talks about the topic first. First, she explains when the vratam is supposed to be done and who all are eligible to do the vratam. And then she calls out to her friends, calling them very beautifully that they are the virtuous ones. Neerirayir. And she also further glorifies them by saying that Seermalgumai paadi selvachirumirgal. You, my friends, are all very rich girls. Selvachirumirgal, she says. Because these girls are rich in their devotion to Krishna. And where do these girls belong to? From where are these rich girls coming? Seermalgum aipadi selvachirumirgal, she says. These girls are coming from Gokulam, And that Gokulam is again rich. It is rich with the goodness of Krishna. Krishna has shown all his grace and mercy and goodness to everybody there. So it has become enriched with goodness. So this enriched Gokulam, Sirmalgu Maipadi, is the resident place of these Gopikas. Now, we have to understand one thing, that Andal is performing this Vratam at Srivilliputtur and her friends are also from the same place. So why is she talking about Gokulam here? Here, Purvacharyas clarify that Andal is into a state of imitation at its maximum. They call it Bhavana Prakarsham. She has got into the role of those Gopikas at the time of Krishna so much that she feels that she herself is a Gopika and her friends are fellow Gopikas. And that Srivilliputtur is Gokulam and the Lord Vatapatra Shai at the temple is Lord Krishna himself. So she is imagining herself as a Gopika and she is completely into that character. And so she addresses her friends also as Gopikas, the rich Gopikas from the rich Gokulam. So she says that what are we going to do in this Vrata? You people who are desirous of being devoted can do this Vrata. But what are we going to do in this Vrata and about whom are we going to do this Vrata? For whom are we going to do this Vrata? She says, Narayanane. We are doing this Vratam for Narayana. Now, who is this Narayana? These girls are also in the same Bhavana Prakarsham. So, they are also feeling that they are Gopikas. So, they don't know who is Narayana. They only know Krishna. So, Andal clarifies to them, don't worry. This Narayana is none other than our Krishna. Which Krishna is he? Kurvel Kodundolilan Nandagopan Kumaran. That son of Nandagopa, Nandagopan Kumaran. He is that son of that Nandagopa who wields a spear. Kurvel Koduntholilan. Nandagopa has a sharp spear with him. He keeps it sharp every now and then. He keeps on sharpening because he's scared that some demon will come and attack Krishna sometime. So he always wants to be ready to ward off any evil to his dear son Krishna. So he keeps his spear in a very, very perfect condition with a sharp edge. So that's called Kurvel Koduntholilan Nandagopan Kumaran. This Krishna is also the adorable child of Yashoda. How is that Yashoda? Andal describes. Erarndakanni Yashodayilam Shingam. This Yashoda keeps on looking at Krishna. All the time she wants to look at her child because she's so fond of him. Now looking at Krishna all the time has made her eyes wide and beautiful. So Andal describes Yashoda's eyes as Erarndakanni. Erarndakanni Yashodai Ilam Shingam. This Krishna is the little lion of this beautiful eyed Yashoda. This Krishna is also the one who is dark-hued and has a beautiful face as the sun and the moon, she says. Karmeni Chengan Kadirmadiyam Pol Mugattan. The Lord has the form of clouds. He has the color of the clouds and his eyes are beautiful like the red lotus. And his face shines like the sun and the moon. What do you mean by sun and moon? The Gopikas looked at Andal. Andal signified to them that the Lord looks as if he were bright as the sun when he looks at the enemies. And so the enemies run away looking at the scorching heat. But when he looks at us devotees, he is pleasant like the moon. So he is like both Kadir, the sun, and Madi, the moon. Again, Andal is talking about the moon, which is an auspicious thing to be spoken about. So this Krishna, who is the son of the spear-wielding Nandagopa, the beautiful-eyed Yashoda, and who has a face bright as the sun and the moon,
is Lord Narayana himself, and that Narayana alone can grant us what we want by performing this Pavainom. Narayanane namakke parai taruvan. Andal says, to perform the Pavainom, we have to go to Narayana to get certain things like parai. Parai refers to a drum. Drum is required for this Pavainom for completion of some sanctity involved in it. But actually, by saying parai, Andal signifies something secretive, which we will get to know as the ThiruppAvai proceeds. As of now, Andal says, we will go to Narayana, who is none other than Krishna himself, and we'll get parai from him. And we'll proceed to do the Pavainom. Fine. So, we have to take the help of Krishna to do this Pavainom. But whom are we doing this Pavainom for? That is also Krishna, Narayana. So, it means that we are doing the Pavainom for Narayana and with the help of Narayana, that is through Narayana himself. Thus, Narayana becomes both the goal and the path. That's what the elders say as Upeya and Upaya. Upeya is the goal and Upaya is the path. So, Lord Narayana is both the path and the goal for this Vrata. So, let's all proceed to him and proceed with this Vrata. Saying so, she concludes the first Pasuram of ThiruppAvai. The girls are all attentively listening and they want to know what Andal is going to tell them next, which we will hear tomorrow.